Parasympathetic supply of the head and the neck. The parasympathetic supply of the head and the neck is derived from the cranial parasympathetic outflow. The cranial parasympathetic outflow starts by the cell bodies of the preganglionic neurons, which are present in the nuclei of the third, seventh, ninth, and tenth cranial nerve nuclei. We will start by the first nucleus present in the brainstem. This parasympathetic nucleus is called Edinger-Westphal nucleus. Edinger-Westphal nucleus. The Edinger-Westphal nucleus represents the cell bodies of the preganglionic neurons, and from the cell bodies pass the parasympathetic nerve fibers, and the exit of the preganglionic nerve fibers from the CNS through the oculomotor nerve, which is the third cranial nerve. This is the oculomotor nerve, which is the third cranial nerve. The preganglionic fibers pass in the head to terminate in peripheral ganglion, called ciliary ganglion. Where is the ciliary ganglion? The ciliary ganglion present in the orbit, just behind the eyeball. The ciliary ganglion show termination of the preganglionic fibers, and the preganglionic fibers end by synapse with the cell bodies of the postganglionic neurons. Actually, the ciliary ganglion is the cell bodies of the postganglionic neurons. And from these cell bodies of the postganglionic neuron pass the postganglionic parasympathetic fibers to the eyeball to supply two muscles inside the eyeball: the constrictor pupillae, which constrict the pupil, and the ciliary muscle. And the ciliary muscle, which affect the lens of the eye, this is the first nucleus, which is Edinger-Westphal nucleus. Preganglionic fibers pass in the oculomotor nerve. Preganglionic fibers end in the ciliary ganglion. The cell body of the postganglionic neuron present in the ciliary ganglion, and which is one of the peripheral parasympathetic ganglia in the head and the neck. And the postganglionic fibers from the ciliary ganglion enter the eye to supply the constrictor pupillae and the ciliary muscle. The next nucleus, the next parasympathetic nucleus in the brainstem, supplying the salivary gland. Therefore, it is called salivary nucleus. But just below this nucleus, there is another nucleus supplying the salivary glands. Therefore, the upper nucleus is called superior salivary nucleus, and the lower nucleus is called inferior salivary nucleus. The superior salivary nucleus present in the brainstem and represent the cell bodies of the preganglionic fibers, which exit from the CNS through the seventh cranial nerve, which is called the facial. This is the facial nerve, the seventh cranial nerve. The preganglionic fibers synapse into ganglia. The first ganglia is called one of the peripheral parasympathetic ganglia of the head and the neck, called the sphenobalatine ganglion. This is called the sphenobalatine ganglion because it's present in this fossa, this depression in the skull, which is called the trigobalatine fossa. And the ganglion is called the sphenobalatine ganglion. It is also called trigobalatine ganglion due to its presence in the trigobalatine fossa or sphenobalatine ganglion. In the sphenobalatine ganglion end the preganglionic fibers and contain the cell bodies of the both ganglionic neurons. And the branches of this ganglion, of sphenobalatine ganglion, pass to supply the lacrimal and the nasal glands, secretory to tears and secretory to the mucous membrane of the nose. The next ganglion is submandibular ganglion. Submandibular ganglion present in the submandibular region. The submandibular ganglion show termination of the preganglionic fibers from superior salivary nucleus. And contains the cell bodies of the postganglionic nuclei, of the postganglionic cells. And the cell bodies of the postganglionic neurons here, from the branches of the ganglion, pass the postganglionic fibers to supply the submandibular and sublingual salivary glands. Therefore, the superior salivary nucleus, containing the cell bodies of the preganglionic neurons. The fibers of the preganglionic neurons pass in the facial nerve to synapse into peripheral parasympathetic ganglia, sphenobalatine ganglion and submandibular ganglion, to supply lacrimal and nasal gland from the sphenobalatine ganglion and submandibular and sublingual salivary glands from the submandibular ganglion. The inferior salivary nucleus present in the brainstem and represent the cell bodies of the preganglionic neurons. The preganglionic fibers pass in this cranial nerve. This cranial nerve is glossopharyngeal nerve, which is the ninth cranial nerve. These fibers, preganglionic fibers, end in this ganglion, which is called otic ganglion. And the branches from otic ganglion pass to supply the parotid salivary gland. The last parasympathetic nucleus in the brainstem is dorsal nucleus of vagus. The dorsal nucleus of vagus represents the preganglionic, the cells, body of the preganglionic neurons of vagus nerve. The preganglionic fibers comes out from the CNS through the vagus nerve. And from the vagus nerve, the preganglionic fibers pass to terminate in terminal peripheral ganglia. Terminal peripheral ganglia to supply the thoracic organ, heart, intramural ganglia. Intramural mean inside the wall. Mural means wall. Therefore, intramural ganglia in the wall of the bronchi to supply the bronchi and the lung. And terminal intramural ganglia in the GIT. Therefore, the parasympathetic fibers from the dorsal nucleus of vagus supply three vital structures: heart, lung, and GIT. Thank you for good listening and good luck.